Tetanus is a serious but rare condition caused by bacteria getting into a wound. Most people who get tetanus weren't vaccinated against it or didn't complete the entire vaccination schedule. How you get tetanus? Tetanus bacteria can survive for a long time outside the body, and are commonly found in soil and the manure of animals such as horses and cows. If the bacteria enter the body through a wound, they can quickly multiply and release a toxin that affects the nerves, causing symptoms such as muscle stiffness and spasms. The bacteria can get into your body through cuts and scrapes, tears or splits in the skin, burns, animal bites, body piercings, tattoos and injections, eye injuries, injecting contaminated drugs. Tetanus can't be spread from person to person. Symptoms of tetanus. The symptoms of tetanus usually develop 4 to 21 days after infection. On average, they start after around 10 days. The main symptoms include stiffness in your jaw muscles, locked jaw, which can make opening your mouth difficult, painful muscle spasms, which can make breathing and swallowing difficult, a high temperature fever of 38°C 4x4 above, sweating, a rapid heartbeat. Left untreated, the symptoms can get worse over the following hours and days. When to get medical advice? Visit your nearest minor injuries unit or phone 111 if you're concerned about a wound, particularly if it's a deep wound, there's dirt or something inside the wound, you haven't been fully vaccinated, or you're not sure if you have. A healthcare professional will assess the wound and decide whether you need treatment and whether you need to go to hospital. Go immediately to your nearest accident and emergency AE department, or call to emergencies for an ambulance if you develop severe muscle stiffness or spasms. How tetanus is treated? If a healthcare professional thinks you could develop tetanus but you haven't had any symptoms yet, they'll clean your wounds and give you an injection of tetanus immunoglobulin. Tetanus immunoglobulin is a medication containing antibodies that kill the tetanus bacteria. It provides immediate, but short-term, protection from tetanus. If you develop symptoms of tetanus, you'll usually need to be admitted to a hospital intensive care unit ICU, where you may be given a number of different treatments. These could include tetanus immunoglobulin, antibiotics, and medication to relieve muscle stiffness and spasms. Most people who develop symptoms of tetanus eventually recover, although it can take several weeks or months. Tetanus immunization. The tetanus vaccines given as part of the NHS Childhood Immunization Program. The full course of the immunization requires 5 doses, given on the following schedule. The first 3 doses are given as part of the 6-in-1 vaccine at 8, 12 and 16 weeks for all babies born on or after August 1, 2017. A booster dose is given as part of the 4-in-1 preschool booster at age 3 years and 4 months. A final booster is given as part of the 3-in-1 teenager booster between 13 and 18 years of age. This course of 5 doses should provide long-lasting protection against tetanus. However, if you or your child has a deep or dirty wound, it's best to get medical advice. If you're not sure whether you've had the full immunization course, contact your GP surgery for advice. It's possible to fully immunize older children and adults who weren't immunized when they were younger. Tetanus travel jab. Tetanus is found throughout the world, so you should ideally make sure you're fully immunized before traveling abroad. If you've never had a tetanus immunization before, you may be advised to have as many of the 3 initial doses of the vaccine as possible before you leave. There should be 1 month gaps between each dose and complete the full course when you return. If you've been partly or fully immunized, a tetanus shot is usually still recommended as a precaution if you're traveling to an area with limited medical facilities and your last dose of the vaccine was more than 10 years ago. You'll be offered another 3-in-1 teenage booster. This additional booster, which also protects against diphtheria and polio, is usually free on the NHS.